Happy birthday! Oh, hey, I am just making a GIF for a friend's birthday. I could have used one of the thousands that already exist, but I think she'll appreciate this so much more, and it's really easy to make, so stick around and I'll show you how. Hey, I'm Jo from Canva Design School, and I love a good GIF. Or is it pronounced GIF? I don't know. How do you pronounce it? Let me know in the comments. Either way, today's tutorial is all about making one of these. Firstly, I'll show you how to select GIF-worthy video footage, then use Canva to clip it, add text and save it correctly so you can send it to all your friends. I'll even show you how to upload your creation to a global GIF sharing website like Giphy, where millions of people go to discover and share GIFs from around the world. Imagine creating a viral GIF. That would be pretty cool. I wonder, can you put that on your resume? Anyway, I think I'm getting off track. Let's just focus on the basics for now. But before we do, make sure you subscribe to our channel so you get notified next time we release a video. All right, first things first. Let's open Canva's video editor. Go to Create a Design, type in Video, and let's go with this one so it's a square. Next, I'll add some footage. To upload your own, go here and click Upload Files. I'll drag this onto the page. Since it's a bit off center, I'm going to crop it before I do anything else. All right, that's looking good and ready to trim. GIFs can be up to 15 seconds long, but I recommend making them around 5 to 6. Keeping it short will make it loop quicker and hold everyone's attention for that much longer. In Canva's video editor mode, the quickest way to trim a clip is to drag in the edges of the video like this. And for this particular GIF, I want the patting of the cat to continue without any noticeable break. So elements need to be roughly in the same position at the beginning as well as at the end. I can use this preview button here to watch it play, but unfortunately it won't loop until it's downloaded as a GIF. This means I need to be really precise with my cuts. All right, I think that's looking good. To download it, head up here, click download and select GIF. Once it's downloaded to your computer, make sure you open the file in a web browser rather than an image viewer. It's not spot on, but it's looking all right for a first try. If I were to do it again, I'd try adding and removing a millisecond either side to see if it makes any difference, but you get the idea. So let's move on to creating a GIF with some text. And this time I'll show you how you can make GIFs without even having your own footage. Canva has a range of stock videos you can use that are license free. Just type in what you're looking for. This time I want to create something on the funny side, so I'm going to go with this dog video. You need to make sure it's fair between the cats and dogs out there. Right now this looks more weird than funny. It's a very overzealous owner, so I'll need some text to turn that around. And since I plan on using a thick white font, I'll add a black background first, and now for some text. There are a lot of point of view memes and GIFs going around at the moment, so I want to get in on that trend. And let's say the point of view in this situation is the dog. It's not laugh out loud funny, but I'm hoping it'll get a rise out of pet owners. Next, I want to show you how to make a sweet birthday GIF. And yes, it's the one you saw me filming at the beginning of this video. Instead of starting from scratch, I'm going to use a template. Let's see what comes up when I search birthday video. This one's cute. Now let me show you how easy it is to make changes. First, I want to change the dimensions of the design so it's square. And just FYI, GIFs don't need to be square, but the majority are because they present larger on a mobile phone. If you're a Pro or Canva for Teams user, you can click here and enter the size you want, or select any option that will give you a square. If you're a free user, you'll need to head over to the homepage and create a new blank design, then copy and paste in your template. Now, I'll shuffle all the elements around so they sit where they belong. It doesn't have to look exactly the same as before, it just needs to look balanced. See how there's less empty space now? This compact design looks much better. Next, I want to find a new frame for my video, and since I shot it in portrait mode, I need something more square and vertical to match. This one will do. I like that it's simple and I can change the border to match the design. And I'll make this yellow, like this, and now to add my footage. I'd already uploaded it, so I can drag it straight in. And I'll crop it like this. And finally, I'll clip it down to show the best bit. Happy birthday! I think my friend's going to love this. It's much more fun and personal than sending a text message. Okay, remember how I mentioned viral GIFs at the beginning of this video? Now it's time to create a design that can be uploaded to Giphy for others to share. And since I want it to be funny, I'm going to check out some meme templates for inspiration. Let's see what comes up for meme GIF. Okay, I'm liking these contradictory statements, and I think this style could pair well with the footage I have. I think I'll go with this one. And I'll start by adding the footage so you can see what we're working with. It's a video of my friend's small dog ferociously guarding its bone. I'll add it in here, then shorten the clip to focus on the best part. Next, I'll add some text that's funny and relatable. I think most people will be able to relate to this when they're hungry, or should I say hangry. And lastly, I'll delete this section because I'm not making this for a particular Instagram account or business. And now I'll download this like I showed you earlier. Time to upload it to Giphy.com. On the home screen, you'll see there's an upload button. Select that, then choose file. Next, select whether you want your GIF to be public or private. And since I want this to become popular, I'll add lots of different search terms to help users find it. I won't be adding it to a collection, so I'll just scroll on past that and go straight to upload. And there you have it, the GIF is officially live and searchable by others. So whether you're making a GIF for friends or an online audience, I hope you've got everything you need to get started. Let me know in the comments what you plan to make, along with any questions you may have about converting videos to GIFs. Just remember to keep your videos under 15 seconds and use a template to start inspired. Did you enjoy this video? Then please chuck it a like and subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on any other great content. And see the other topics on your screen. If you're not in a hurry, you can check those out too. Or share this with a friend so they can start making GIFs as well. Or GIFs. Anyway, see you soon.